We have launched our new GTO Viewer, which has a completely new and optimized interface, making it even easier for you to study GTO. Today I will walk you through the features, but you can also check it out for yourself for free by going to the link in the description, and there you will be able to sign up for free and you will get 15 big blind heads up ranges for free. You can view those in the GTO Viewer, but you can also train them in our GTO Trainer. When you sign up, you will get to my lobby. Up here you can find all your solutions. If you sign up for free, you will be able to train every single one of them in the trainer demo. But you will also have full access to the 15 big blind heads up ranges, both in the trainer but also in the viewer, and that's what we will focus on in this video. All you have to do is select the solution that you want to study. In this case, we want to look at our free 15 big blind heads up ranges. You can choose to train this in the GTO trainer, but for this video, we want to go to our new GTO viewer and look at the features. As you can see, the viewer has a completely new interface, and then in the top right corner, you will find a settings button. Up here, you can change certain things. You can square the size proportional to the weight combos, and you can also display the bet sizes in a percentage rather than big blinds. Additionally, you have the option to change the strategy rounding. This is particularly useful if you want to study a strategy with a lot of mixing. Here on the left side of your screen, you can see what solution you're currently browsing. In this case, the heads up MTT 15 big blinds, but you can also use it to select a different sim from the same sim group. In the top left corner, you can find a game tree. Here you can select the action for each player and go through the hand. When you click on an action, you can see that ranges are being populated. When you've selected the action for each player, you can now input the board. A new feature is that they are now isomorphic boards, allowing you to represent the exact suits. Here you can select the exact board that you wish to study. If you wish to change the board, you can easily change it by clicking on either the cards on the table or in the game tree. Another new function is that you can now easily change the action for a player without completely losing the game tree. Additionally, it has become much easier to navigate the game tree as you are now able to quickly select a different action for a player. Another way to study the solutions available is by making use of the Preflop Quick Select. You can find this also on the left side of your screen, and all you have to do is select the action that you want to study, in this case for example Preflop versus 3-bet. Then what you want to do is select the hero, the position that you want to study, in this case under the gun, and then all you have to do is choose the villain that you want to study against, for example under the gun versus a button 3-bet. When you do that, you can see that the game tree is now automatically filled. You can actually do the exact same thing for postflop. Click here on the left side to select the flop and then select the action that you want to study. For example, here the 3-bet pots. In this case, we want to, for example, study cutoff versus button 3-bet. All you have to do is once again click on it and then select the board that you want to study, and it will automatically populate the ranges and the strategy that you want to study. When you've done that, you can see here on the bottom left the range that the cutoff calls versus a button 3-bet. You can see the button 3-betting range, and you can see the strategy for the cutoff once they got to a flop. The actions are also being represented on the table, and once again, you can easily change the board by just clicking on it and changing the board to however you wish. Another new function is the all player strategy graph. Here you can see the actions for all the players left to act for this specific spot. In this case, first in. You can see how much under the gun, for example, wants to fold and how often it wants to raise, but the same for the button or for the small blind. This makes it really easy to get a quick overview for a specific spot. Aside from these graphs, you are also able to visualize these ranges. You can click here on the All Players tab, allowing you to visualize the ranges for each player, but you can also browse it across multiple stack sizes. In the mini grids here at the bottom, it will show us default D ranges, but for postflop, you can actually change this to the EV, the equity, or the equity realization. Between the mini grids, you can find a new info panel. This panel has a lot of information, for example, how many combos there are in each range, what the EVs are of the ranges, the equities, the equity realization, and you can group the ranges by, for example, made hands, as well as the draws that each range have. And as you can see, it's also interactive, and you can also group it, for example, by the equity groups. What do we want to do with the top 25% of our hands? What do we want to do with the bottom 25% of our hands? As you can see, all these info panels are interactive, and you can also hover over the combinations to see the exact weights. If you want to copy your range into a solver, you can easily do so by clicking here on the copy button. On the right side of your screen, you can see the strategy view. When you hover over the combinations, you see a breakdown for each suit, and you can also filter it by using those buttons. At the bottom of the overview, you can see the frequencies for the range, and you can also easily highlight them by clicking on them. Above the grid, you can also see the spot name as well as a bar chart of the actions available, and you can easily train it in the trainer by clicking on the bets here. Additionally, you can see here your trainer performance for the specific spot. A hot new feature that we added is called Strategy React. This allows you to think one step ahead. It allows you to see how certain combinations react to certain actions of your opponent. As default, it will show all, but we can also choose to look at a specific line. For example, what if we decide to bet big as under the gun here? We can see all the combinations that we want to do it with, as well as what we do with those combinations when the big blind raises us. An additional tab that you have here is the aggregated reports tab. You can only browse this if you have Range Pro or when you browse the free 15 big blind hand subranges. This reports tab allows you to view the macro strategy, which is super helpful to spot trends. On what boards do we want to bet very often? On what boards do we have a lot of EV? You can sort these by clicking on it, but you can also filter it if you like. Additionally to that, we have this histogram feature that allows you to either select the out of position player or the in position player. You can once again filter it to however you like. You can click on the actions. And another thing that you can do is you can also zoom in. When you've gotten to the turn or the river, the histogram will turn into a turn or river heat map. You can filter this by suit if you wish. You can look at the strategies, but also at the equity or the EV. Last but not least, you can train these solutions by clicking on the play button here, or if you want to share the solution with someone, you can click on the link button. As you can see, there are many cool features that help you to get the most out of your study, making studying GTO a breeze. So I would recommend you to sign up for free through the link in the bio, and you will get 15 big blind heads up ranges for free to familiarize yourself with the software, and we will be uploading many tutorials to help you to get the most out of it. So make sure to sign up and also to subscribe to this channel so you don't miss any of these videos.